When did it become breaking a rule to say your name out loud in school? When your name's the only one that sets us free? When did it become incorrect?
All right. So Justina and Jabal, we have Brother Richard right here, who's the shark. Now this is the idea you all have to pitch in 1 minute. You all have to give us, now you talked about cutting hair. So you have to pitch to us either your hair salon business or your barbershop business. Now what should be the pitch? You have to come up with a creative name for your shop. Amy, stand in the middle. All right, Justina, what do you call?
Huh?
What do you call? Heads or tails? Tails. All right, go ahead and flip that coin for me. Well, I don't think that's gonna rotate. Tails.
Okay, so the name of my company would be Hair by Hershey. My nickname is Hershey.
Started getting a little tired. You know what? You know what, guys? I think
As soon as he said he was gonna go back down, one of his friends looked at him and said this statement that I'll never forget. He looked at him and said, my brother, in life, if you're going to make it to the top, you can only take what is necessary for the climb. We're introduced to Jesus performing a miracle. The miracle that he performs is that he feeds a crowd of 5,000 plus. As he feeds the crowd of 5,000 plus, Jesus performs this miracle for a specific purpose. He performs the miracle so that he can help the people look beyond the physical to the spiritual. He performs the miracle so that he can help the people look beyond the temporal to the eternal. However, the crowd misses Jesus' point. And so in chapter 6, verse 24, they are so bent on finding Jesus that they hop on some boats and go across the lake in search of Jesus. Man, they make it to Jesus, and we find in verse 27 that when they make it to their goal, when they make it to Jesus, according to verse 27, they say, oh, Rabbi, where have you been? Jesus, understanding their real reason for looking for him, takes a step back and provides an answer to the crowd. Jesus said, very truly I tell you, you are looking for me not because you saw the signs. You're only looking for me because you ate the loaves and now your stomach has had its fill. He says, but don't be so concerned. Oh, come on, y'all, don't miss this. This one is good. This one is good. It says, but don't be so concerned about spending your energy on temporary things like food. Instead, concern yourself with spending your energy on permanent things, like seeking the eternal life that the Son of Man can give you. In other words, what Jesus is saying is this. Jesus is saying to you and I that if you focus on your earthly priorities at the expense of your spiritual priorities, you will end up missing out on your heavenly destination. Pew Research Center asked a question. The question that they asked was this. They asked the question, what are the life priorities of millennials? So let me tell you the first one. I was really shocked on this. First one is this. According to the research, they said the first priority of millennials is being a good parent. That was the first one. But then I thought about it. I said, you know what? Half of my friends want kids in their lives. You know what I'm saying? The second priority, they say, is having a successful marriage. That's the second priority that they said of millennials. Now, this one, I believed it all the way. This is Ghanaian women 100%. I'll let that go. All right. So, number one, being a good parent. Number two, having a successful marriage. Number three, helping others that are in need. Number four, owning a home. Number five, being successful in a high-paying career. Does everyone see these priorities? But the problem becomes this. The problem becomes when we start to focus on these priorities at the expense of the higher spiritual priorities. We're so concerned about all these things that we're no longer concerned about keeping the Sabbath holy. We're so concerned about all these things that we're no longer concerned about doing things such as getting baptized and following Jesus Christ. This yellow rope over here represents a timeline. It represents a what, everyone?
Timeline.
Represents a timeline. This white part of the rope right here represents your time while you're here on earth. It represents the time you're born, time to go to middle school, high school, college, hopefully find a spouse, or maybe marriage is not for you. Your job, your retirement, and if Jesus don't come back, it represents the time you die. Is everyone following? Right here. Now the rest of this rope, represents eternity with Jesus Christ. Are you seeing this? Are you seeing me?
Yes.
Then I remember looking at my friend. I don't know why I said this response, but you know, you're supposed to show comfort and sympathy towards your friend. Nah, not that day. I look at him, I said, bruh, you told me that I was missing out from the party. I said, your grade is about to take a major hit. It looks like you're the one who is really missing out. Stick with me, y'all. I'm making a point. You see, as a young person, when you choose to follow Jesus, people who are of the world, people who have not chosen to follow Jesus, what they will do is that they will look at you and they will say, you're missing out. They'll look at you and you'll say that you're missing out from the drugs, you're missing out. They'll look at you and they'll say you're missing out from the fame, you're missing out. They'll look at you and they'll say that you're missing out from the nightlife, you're missing out. But this is what I'm here to tell you today. I am here to tell you today that if you are in Jesus, you can look at those individuals and say, you think I'm missing out. That's okay. Because I'm just missing out on what's right here. You're missing out on everything that has to follow over here. The point that I'm making is that we spend so much of our energy focusing on the priorities right here. And what we don't realize is that the investments that we're making right here is going to impact the type of life that we live right here. Jesus is coming back to get you. And the scripture says,